All right, in these notes, we're going to take a look at 4.6, which is a summary of curve sketching. And essentially, we're taking everything that we've learned so far and putting it into practice and getting a good idea or a good picture of what these graphs look like. So the goal is not to get exactly the graph. We graphed it with a on our calculators, but to get an approximation of what the graph's doing. And these are some of the things that we're going to look at and what we're going to test. Obviously x and y intercepts we learned way back in algebra 1 are very important and are easy ways to determine where the graph crosses over your x and y axis. Symmetry, domain range, continuity. If there's any vertical or horizontal asymptotes, we need to look at those as well. Differentiability, relative extrema, you're looking at maxes and mins. Concavity, points of inflection, and horizontal asymptote. So concavity, points of inflection, I don't tend to use those all that much, but they can be helpful depending on what type of graph you're looking at. Let's take a look at some simple guidelines for sketching these graphs. Number one, determining the domain and range. That can be pretty important trying to figure out what are x values that can't be put in there because that can tell you your vertical asymptotes, setting both the numerator and denominator equal to zero. And number two, determining the intercepts, asymptotes, and symmetry of the graph is locating the x values for where the first derivative and the second derivative or zero or don't exist. Because remember, if they don't exist, those are different points we want to look at as well. And then using those to find the relative extrema. Through even as we go through the year, most of what we do in here, I know I've said it once and a million times, I'll say it again. Most of what we do is just algebra on steroids. So it's taking what you learned in algebra and just continuing to build on that, those ideas, and those understandings. Let's go ahead and look at an example. Use these principles right here, these skills. And go ahead and graph this function right here, 2 times the quantity of x squared minus 9 all over x squared minus 4. Do that without a calculator. Remember, it doesn't need to be perfect, but get a good idea of what that graph is looks like. Pause the video, try this on your own, and then come back to see how you did. So take a look at what I decided to do. Again, the way that you do things may be a little bit different, and that's fine, but generally you want to get an idea of the behaviors of the graph. Like, for example, the x and y intercepts are really important. So setting the function equal to zero will give you the y intercept, setting it equal to zero will give you the x intercept. Plugging x zero in for x will give you the y intercept. So we have those and put those on the graphs over here. We know that it cross our graph crosses at those points. Then the next thing that you can do is go ahead and set the denominator equal to zero because that'll give us any vertical asymptotes. And so that's what I did down here, setting the denominator equal to zero. I know that there are vertical asymptotes, so I'm going to go ahead and put those in. Right here, there's one at negative 2, and to move that negative 3 over right there. Okay, and because they're vertical asymptotes, my graph comes really close. So we're not really sure what sides. So we look at our y-intercept. We know it's at 4.5, so our graph crosses up here as well. And then looking at maxes and mins, we know at when by said finding the derivative. So right here, I found the derivative. And I set the derivative equal to zero. I know that there is a relative extrema at zero. So I use the first derivative test to try to figure out. So right here's doing the first derivative test, and it decreases on the left side of zero and increases on the right side of zero. So my minimum is x equals zero. Because of that, I know my graph, there's an asymptote there, comes down, touches there. And there's an asymptote there. Now I have to figure out, okay, it crosses at 3, but it could look different ways, right? So we have to see, okay, what are my y values to the right of 3? What are my y values to the left of 3? Or you can think, is it always increasing, always decreasing? Does it? There's a lot of different ways. It might be easiest if you just plug in to your function, right? So plug in 4 to see if it's above or below. So if you plug in 4, you get a value that's greater than 0, so it's positive. That means that your graph is above right there. All right, and since it's an x squared, we know that it's going to be symmetric. So it's going to look something like this. And you can also think about end behavior. So if you take the end behavior of the function, so that would be the limit as x approaches positive and negative infinity of your function, you would essentially get something that simplifies down to 2. So at y equals 2, there is a horizontal asymptote. And that gives me the rest of what I need, because I know it never crosses over that, never crosses over that. It's symmetric, so it's going to be the same thing on that side. Okay, so like I said, you might have used different methods, different techniques. If you need to screenshot that, screenshot it. But we're all getting there. Looking at the asymptotes is really helpful. Looking at the end behavior is really helpful as well. All right, let's try one more. Let's look at this one. Sketching or analyzing the graph of x over the square root of x squared plus 2. Do some of those same things that we did and get a good idea of what this graph is going to look like before you check it with a graphing calculator. Pause the video, try this, come back, and see how you did. It took a little bit more work to try to figure out what was happening, even though it's a much simpler looking graph. Just we don't find out as much because it has 0, it doesn't have a vertical asymptote. The end behavior, however, the end behavior plugging in as x approaches infinity gives you 1 and negative 1, which is where these horizontal asymptotes came from. And my x and y intercepts were both 0, so that points to the origin. So it crosses through the origin, has horizontal asymptotes at y equals 1 and negative 1. Then trying to figure out what the derivative, that was a bit weird too, because I went through and I found the derivative and I set it equal to 0. So I set the numerator equal to 0. And I found out that once I simplified it down, I got this quadratic that you couldn't solve. There's no solution. Means there's no extrema. So this thing is always either increasing or always decreasing. So it either looks like this, right? Here's an asymptote, goes through, or it looks like that. And we just, there's a couple of different tests we could do to figure out which one of those it is. And really, all I did was plug in 0 to your derivative to see if you get a positive or negative answer, and plugging in 0. So I plugged it in back here, right? I got the square root of 2 minus 0 all over 2. That's a positive answer, so my slope is always positive. That means my graph looks like something like this. It's got an asymptote down there, an asymptote right there because of the end behavior. And it never doesn't have an extrema, it's always increasing. Okay, so that one was a little trickier because we didn't, there's just not much to it. But looking at the end behaviors, asymptotes, intercepts, and what the slope is doing, whether it's increasing or decreasing given certain values, that gave us enough of a picture that we can go ahead and sketch that graph. The last one that I do in this video, there are several more on the notes that I have handed out in class. If you have any questions or you want to go over some of these, but it's all the same technique. So you do the exact same thing for different graphs, and different stuff works well with graphs. Like for this one, was more difficult because there's just not much to it. So just try different things, look at the end behaviors, the asymptotes, what's happening with the derivative, where the extrema, where the x and y intercepts are really helpful as well. But just continue plugging away at it until you get a good picture of what those graphs look like.